Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Rainbow Skies. Okay, so today we are going to actually go ahead and continue on with our main quest, The Scientist. But just before that, I want to very quickly try and go ahead and complete this Monster Hunt 13 that we picked up in the last episode. So the quest step is, the practicer lives in a hidden area of Lost Tarunan. It only appears if you have its favourite food with you. Ask at the Witching House for more details. I actually went back into the Witching House, and in the last episode we found a sort of drawing board that actually said that the prankster likes 5 chicken legs. I also went back and talked with all of the witches in the house, and one of them actually says that it also likes 4 carrots. And then I obviously went down to the area where it did say it spawns, and there's actually a signpost that says it needed 3 bread. So I feel like we've got to have at least all of these items in our inventory in order for it to spawn. So we'll go to this food shop. So we've got 4 chicken legs just now, but we need 5. We need 3 fresh breads and 4 carrots. That's all I think we need. I haven't found any more signs or anything around about to actually see if it needed anything else. And I should already have enough items to use in the battle. I'm not sure if it's going to be a strong battle or not, so I'm not really sure if I'm actually going to be able to defeat it right now. If you come through this little gap here, I think that's the monster hunt there. This signpost here is actually says that it needed the 3 fresh breads. So let's see, I just want to have a quick little look what it is. It's level 80, sorry, so there's a possibility. We are level 85, so right, what I want to do is actually use up some items. How many speed potions do I have? Right, I've got 4 speed potions, but I kind of feel like I want to keep them because I'm now starting to run out. Attack buffs, I could probably get away with using attack buffs, to be honest with you, so, but it only lasts for 30 seconds, so right, we'll use an attack buff on everybody, and probably use, I was going to say we could use a defense buff. I was hoping I'd maybe have a bit more there, but alright, you know what, I'll go with that. Fingers crossed we actually managed to survive. I was hoping we'd actually have a turn right away with that speed boost, but sadly not. They do actually hit very hard. I think these are actually all new enemies, to be honest with you. I can't remember if I've seen them or not before. It's possibly I haven't, so I might have to do a quick x-ray on everybody here. Fingers crossed this doesn't hurt a lot. Oh, you've got a regeneration as well. That's not nice of you. The good news is you're all kind of blocking each other in, so fingers crossed we survive. Come on, there we go. Oh, okay, that's not too bad. So let's very quickly do an x-ray on these. I can't remember if, as I say, if we've already x-rayed these set of monsters yet, so we'll just do it anyway while we're here. Okay guys, welcome back. Sorry about that, unfortunately I got a phone call. Right, okay, I was going to do an x-ray on these people, weren't I? Right, we'll start with the guys in front. Again, I can't remember if I've already done them or not. So these guys have 3050 HP, 45 MP, strength 1360, speed 1100, defense 828, and I think luck was 1000 there. We'll do the guys behind, just in case. So they have 2950 HP, 100 MP, strength 1100, speed 1080, defense 820, and luck was 40. And the prankster, probably has a lot, has 100,000 HP, 1500 MP, strength 50,000, speed 1360, defense 848, and I didn't catch luck there. There's definitely a lot of HP, and luck is 4. So that's actually quite a lot. Okay. So we'll have to start off, let's say all three people get a turn, that's fine. So we just clear out the guys in front. Oops. I'm going to put Spike Panic back on. Hopefully they'll put some bags in front of us. Well, that's okay for Ashley, so she's got a bag in front. I was kind of hoping, yeah, that might actually work, to be honest, because he's not going to get through that gap. So fingers crossed there's a bag in front of Lane, which isn't. I'm quite sad about that. Let's just use a potion and defend. Play the frogs. Hopefully you put a bag in front of that little gap there as well, please. It'd be nice, and no, that's a shame. I was hoping it would cover Lane as well, but sadly not. Okay, so we'll do another Plague of Frogs. Hopefully it can be poisoned if possible. Doesn't feel like it's going to happen. No, alright. We'll just defend just now, and we'll use at least another potion to make sure everybody's topped up. Seems like it. Okay. See if we can just now start whittling down this enemy. It would have been nice if I could have dazed it, but sadly not. Health's going down pretty rapidly as well, so that's good. So we'll just defend again. Fingers crossed it's not going to hit us too hard. Alright, so that's weird. I feel like you're going to go straight for Damien here, which I'm happy to do. Oops, that's what I want to do. Right. Come on, let's see if we can get a daze on the next two shots. Oh, alright, we'll just defend. It's a possibility it is going to go for Ashley. But sadly, I'm going to try and finish this off now. So it's actually not a bad boss at all. Obviously, we haven't really been hit by it, but there we go. We've managed to actually kill it off, so that's good enough for me. Right, so what have we actually got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 8. 8 pouches of gemstones, so that's not too bad. I can cash them in for more money. 25 blue skill stones, a red skill stone, 600 coins, 59 coins, an anti-tonic, untuned trumpet. Stats aren't too bad, it's only a strength 8, but we'll take it. A cursed bell. I actually used these to actually put on my weapons as, currently. That's where they've got the anti-casting from, so we'll take the cursed bell. The 4 red skill stones and the 3 red skill stones. I'm kind of hoping there'd maybe be a drop of gear for this one, but sadly not. But I'm definitely going to take that victory anyway. Let's see what we've got. 6,750,000 XP, so that's actually quite a lot. Alright, I'm definitely going to take that anyway, so let's actually head back to Mary now, I think it was, that gave us the quest originally. Oh, okay, so all the enemies have started to spawn back in this area. That's fine, so let's talk to Mary again.
What's happening?
Yeah, it wasn't actually too bad. I think the bag's placement actually helped us there, so I'll definitely take that as a win. I'm quite happy. See, sometimes it just works, sometimes it doesn't. You just get lucky. Okay, so let's take item. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 speed tonics with a plus 4 on it. That's actually quite a lot. Might have definitely come in handy. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 big health tonics. Again, I could probably put them on Ashley. And 800 rainbow coins. There we go. Definitely worth it. So we've got side quest Monster Hunt 13 successfully completed. Let's talk to Mary again. No? Nothing else for us? Alright, that's fine. We'll just very quickly head back into town. I wonder if I'm actually able to take on this pot very soon. You never know. Just need to be careful for all the enemies are now starting to spawn back in this area again. May have to go ahead and clear them all out before we do anything else. So what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to go ahead and heal up and sort out my inventories before we actually go ahead and talk to Rhonda Sand and see what he wants. So I'll be right back.
There.
Well, hello would be good for a start. Hi, hello. How are you? Ah, maybe he's just a wee bit excited. Well, there you go then, you know, that's it. Maybe we're new in town, he's quite happy to see new faces. Oh, are you from Arca? Well, I've never seen you. Well, I'm guessing it's going to be bad if we've stopped these towers that were given mana. Right, you're losing me now anyway. Yeah, I sort of thought that a while back, that if we're stopping these towers, were we the ones then that basically caused it to, you know, fall? I think that's what everybody else is just now getting in their head. I'm wondering if we'll ever actually find out who's behind it all. Well, yeah, kind of. If we're the ones actually stopping these towers, then surely it would be our fault if it falls. Really? Why are you delighted then? Is it just because it's not your fault or anybody else's? It's ours? Well, why is that then? Well, I wouldn't necessarily call it the right thing to do. Look how everybody's living right now, they're all in sludge. I guess we are to blame then, we're the one who buggered up that place. Oh yeah, I guess. At one point you are going to eventually run out of a resource, so... Well, fair enough, it wouldn't have been our fault if it eventually fell, but technically it is our fault if it falls sooner rather than later, to be honest with you. Maybe just need to try and find another source, I guess? Well, I'd say we've got courage, but whether we've got the skill to build things, I doubt it. Okay, place of foresight and last magnas, okay. Can we go there? Oh well, guess that's where we are going. I can't remember half this story half the time. Why would we want to go back to the past? We've just got here just now. I'm sure there's still plenty of things to do here. Yay, that's good. I'm quite happy for some help. good. Actually, something's going our way then. Oh, come on, there's always something on our way. Beetle goo. Ah, so well, I bet they're going to be bloody massive then. Well, we can squash them, then it means we've got the goo. Problem solved. Alright, so I guess we've got to go talk to that strange witch that's standing outside the witching house. I'm sure we will. She keeps telling us to clear off anyway, so. We know where she is. Unless she's moved. Sure, why not? As long as it doesn't go horribly wrong for us. Alright, quest updated. Rhonda Sand sends you to an old lady named of Elvira, or Elvira. She has the key of brittles for phlegm and can also brew drinks. Perfect, fair enough. Very quickly talk to him. Well, again, it wasn't really your fault. I'd still say it's our fault. Right, let's actually head out of here. Go try talk to her. I think she's round this way. Nope, she's round the other way. I don't like when it's all cornered off a little bit like this. It means having to walk all the way around here for nothing. Right, can you give us the key, please, to enter phlegm?
Hello.
Well, we don't want to battle. I don't really want to do that. Aww. See, they're still friends at heart. Well, that's not very nice if they drove you out. Surely your witching friends will be nice to you. Aww. Yeah, but look, you've got a absolute nice pair of wings there. Come on. Come on, just give me the key, please. Yeah, technically if we stop Arca from falling from the sky, you won't turn into this. Granted, I'd still like to keep the wings, to be honest with you. It must come in quite handy if you can fly. Hey, I'm quite happy to jump in there, to be honest with you. I'm sure we'll be fine. There's no need to really worry there, come on. Sure we've had worse situations. Well, he's probably obviously not going to tell you it. Maybe he's secretly scared of beetles. Aww. Wonder if the two of them are going to get it on. They seem to like each other. Right, come on, we're wasting valuable time here. Yay, finally. As long as there's no big bad enemies in there, I'm sure we'll be fine. Alright, that's fine.
Yeah.
See, we're now a man with a plan, so technically that woman were right in that woman's eye there who wanted the fish. Right, so let's take item, and we've got the key of Bristol's, so take that. New item discovered, quest updated. Elvira has given you the key of Bristles for Phlegm. Look for the four portions of beetle goo. She's waiting at the entrance. Fair enough. Right, so we're just heading over here, so it's fine. I did go off and take care of all the enemies that kind of respawned in this area, so... Oh, there you're there. That was quick. I don't need to heal myself up, so that's fine. So let's just talk with her again.
Hello.
I'm sure we can. We've managed to survive so far. That's fine, we'll definitely find them all, I'm sure. So quest updated, she's waiting for the four potions of beetle goo, which you can find in Phlegm. Talk to her again when you have them all. Fair enough. Let's just go ahead and jump in here then. So let's use item and head on in. Well, there's a couple of enemies in here right away, so that's not a good start. I need to put on some marathon runners. Nope. Magic Torch, that'll do it. The good thing is I do have the passive skill on that basically stops enemies from removing gear. That was one of the worst things about these type of ghost enemies doing that. Alright, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 hidden treasures in this area, so just want to double check this little side. Nope, nothing. Okay. So there is quite a few enemies in here. Got a treasure chest. Let's take on this horn zombie. Okay guys, welcome back. So I very quickly went ahead and cleared out all the enemies in this dungeon that I basically came across, just to sort of save a bit of time. We have already collected one hidden treasure, so we've got another 60 find, and we're at 69% progress of exploration. So let's now hopefully explore this dungeon in full, and hopefully we don't encounter any new enemies. It was, of course, just more of those death ghosts and final tombs, so there was no new enemies that I came across, so let's head down this one. There was obviously an enemy blocking this path. I think it was the same for each of these staircases that lead down the way, so let's see what's in this bag. Got an attack buff, so we'll definitely take that. And oh, something there, there's an eye. Beetle goo. Okay, that's fine. We'll take that. And it's a new item discovered, so I'm guessing there's going to be a part down each of these stairwells. Hopefully. Nothing else in here. Right, let's see. Got a treasure chest. Fingers crossed it's not a battle one. Nope. Okay, it's good. It's just tombs. Skill stones, sorry. So we've got 70 blue skill stones, 30 red skill stones, 15 yellow skill stones, and 300 rainbow coins. That's fine. Let's see. So there's a way down there. We'll just work our way up the way and work our way around, I think. I think that's where the first hidden treasure was. So let's go down this staircase. And again, there was another enemy blocking this part here. Nothing of any interest at all. Oh, there's one. A +5 strength tonic, so we'll take that. And Annette. Beetle Goot. So that's what, the second one? So I think we've got four to find. There we go. Another one. Shadow Potion. That's fine. And oops, we've got four more to find, so we're getting there. Just keep continuing on round this way. Just want to make sure I keep hugging the sides a bit. There's a bag. Three yellow crystals and a revive three. It kind of looks like that'd be a good place to have a little secret bit, wouldn't it? There's no dug up treasures in this area, so. Let's see, I think that's everything that I can do that way, so we'll continue on this way just now. Got a bag, a super potion, a hamburger, and 200 rainbow coins. Fair enough. Let's see what's down this one. Okay. There's a hidden treasure there. 11 yellow skill stones. Okay. A tooth. It's Beetlegoo. Okay, that's fine. For a second there, I thought it was like one of those rotten tooths that you find. What's this? Oh, poison, okay. It's hitting me, so I'm gonna try and. Two gigantic flasks, okay. Now, the good thing is, I don't think this really kills me, I think it just saps all my health down, so I wanna actually explore it. Make sure there's no hidden. Oh, I think there was one there. There it is. An energy potion, that's fine, so you need to just double check that when you're in the poison mist that there is one here. That's fine. As long as it doesn't kill any of my characters, I'm happy with that. It shouldn't really do, I don't think. Obviously, as I say, I've been trying to keep everybody alive and try and keep that defeated allies at zero as much as possible, so I'm not going to heal up just now, because if there is any more of that poison around, I'd rather wait until I've explored everything, because I don't want to waste any health or not. Oh, there's one there as well. A twisted scrunchie. Okay, so it's not for any of our party. Again, it's for monsters. But I'll take it anyway, seeing as it's a new item discovered. Right, let's see. What have we got left? One more hidden treasure to find. That's fine. So there is more poison mist there. There's another way down there. What does this do? Oh, it heals me back up. That's actually quite handy to have there, to be honest with you. Just heals everybody up from that poison mist. At least I'm not gonna waste any of my own potions, to be honest with you, so I'm happy with that. Quite glad I stumbled upon that. Right, we'll get that in a second. I want to check out this poison here. There's a treasure chest at the end of it. Let's open it. It's 300 rainbow coins, 2 mana tonics with a plus 4, and 3 luck potions with a plus 6, and a green crystal. Okay, let's just walk through this again. Right, let's just use that thing to heal us up again. Just need to keep walking through it, I think. Right, let's see. I just want to double check we've been round. We've been in there. We've worked our way all the way around. So this is definitely the only place left to go. So we'll open this bag. It's 225 rainbow coins and a magic flask. Right, this should be the last stairwell, I think, then. Oh, there's another one there. 190 rainbow coins, and all hidden treasures have been found in the area, so that's good. Let's see, so there's poison mist over there. Put my marathon runner back on. There's another bag. 11 yellow skill stones, that's fine. More poison, let's go. Oh, there's another treasure chest. Okay, so that's good. We've got ourselves a moon trophy there, so at least it wasn't a big waste of time coming in here, even though it was for our main quest, so I'm going to write that down. Right, so we'll take the moon trophy and the 300 rainbow coins, that's good. Just want to double check there's nothing else hidden in these corners, nothing that I can see, that's fine. Let's see what's down here. Oh, okay. What's that? Flying fully explored. That's fine. But what are you? Oh, okay. So I guess I'm going to be fighting you. Alright, well, just before I do that then, are you going to move? Or are you going to just stay there? That's fine. What I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to run back and heal myself up, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, welcome back. So I very quickly went ahead and healed myself up. So let's just have a quick little look at what level this thing is. Level 75 with a caution and 13 enemies, okay. Let's see, what's flashing in my inventory here? It's just that twisted scrunchie, that's fine. And key items was the goo and the moon trophy, so that's okay. Right, wanna have a quick little look at see what buffs I've got here to use. I've got four of the attack buffs again, so I feel like I could probably put them on. Let's see, I just wanna double check the defense. Okay. Definitely feel like I should go with an attack buff just to try and get some more speed in. Fingers crossed I can probably get a couple of hits in first. So we'll definitely have to just go ahead and use attack buffs. See if that works for us. So let's go. Okay, so we've got Horn, Zombies and Final Tombs. So, right, I want to very quickly clear out these Final Tombs. There we go, and we'll just defend. We'll try and clear out some of these zombies. Not sure how hard the boss is going to hit, but I'll take a chance. I would have liked at least a couple of bags in front of me to block the way, but it doesn't seem like it would make much difference, seeing as he has a long-range attack. That's fine, as long as he keeps hitting Damien, we should be fine. Let's see, I'm actually going to put on regeneration, to be honest with you. If he does go after Damien, might be worthwhile doing. There we go. And I will just go ahead and use a mighty flask and defend. Now, I want to kind of... Let's see, actually, we want to do an x-ray, don't we? We haven't done that yet. So it's a compound die. It has 135,000... HP, that's a lot. 1000 MP, and I think that was 18,000 strength. Yep, speed is 1260, defense is 840, and luck is 40. So it is quite high, that's fine though. I want to see if I can use Spike Panic to daze it. Fingers crossed. Nope, didn't seem to hit there, that's a shame. I still want to keep my distance from him with everybody else, so definitely gonna have to be long range attacks and defend. That's it, go for Damien, he's got the most HP out of a lot of you, so that's what I want you to do. Granted he has 6 turns, so that's quite a lot. Fireball seems to do the most amount of damage out of Ashley and Lane, so definitely feel like Fireball is better for her. We can defend. Now, I want to see if Force Blow would work. Seems like it would. I was just trying to see if it would take more damage off rather than Spike Panic, but seems like it's roughly the same per 2 turns. I could probably kill it off, to be honest with you, with this next turn from Lane, so let's just go ahead and kill it. So it wasn't really too bad as long as it attacks Damien, to be honest with you. So, right, we've got our fourth Beetle Goose, so we'll take that. We've got 5 yellow skill stones, 200 rainbow coins, a red crystal, 1800 rainbow coins, 90 rainbow coins, and 46 rainbow coins. Sadly, I was hoping we'd probably get a bit of gear out of that, but sadly not. But let's see how much XP it's going to give us. 5.8 million, that's actually quite a lot. I'm about halfway there now towards level 88, so that's good for me. Right, so let's just double check there's nothing else behind this creature. Nope, nothing at all. Okay, so we've got all the hidden treasures, we've got 100% exploration, so we can now leave here, I think. I feel like I've got everything. I don't feel like there's any little corners that I've missed or anything, so we'll just heal ourselves up while we're here. Make sure everybody's topped up, and let's get out of here then. This might actually be a good little level grinding area. Hopefully, I don't think I've actually caught any, what do you call them, monster eggs from in here, I don't think. I'm going to have a quick little look just to be sure that if I haven't, I might need to go back in and try and farm one or two of them. That's just a plain zombie. That's just a lurker. Got the bronze urchin, got the golem, got the spike. Nope, I don't seem to have actually spent a lot of time getting any of them so far, so I'll definitely have to maybe jump back in there before continuing on. Right, let's talk with Elvira.
Hello.
Well, we've done it, so wasn't too bad actually. Well, you shouldn't doubt us, we're actually pretty good at what we do. I wouldn't necessarily call you a master swordsman. I'd say you're good at defence, right enough. You can surely take at least a good hit anyway. Yeah, well, there was quite a big one. Why does everybody have a recipe book? Why not just call it a spell book? Oh, come on, you need to man up a little bit, Ashley. Granted, you are standing like right in front of a pile of gunk there with some flies flying around it, so. Aye, there's always a bit of singing involved, it seems like. Oh god, everybody just seems to sing that one bloody Billy Flash song. Of course you are. It seems like every girl is. Oh, better be careful, she's gonna get jealous of you now. Told you, I knew it was going to happen. If you start telling somebody you've met them, they're going to be like, that's not fair, why are you meeting them and I'm not? Yeah, we've got our potion of portals. Well, I'm quite happy to try and prevent it, but I'm not sure if we can. Right, so we've got to obviously head back to Rondason, that's fine. So we've got to drink it all. I'm sure it'll taste lovely. I wonder if we'll actually meet you in the past, see if you're any different. Right, so let's deliver the wanted items, okay, and take item. Yeah, we finally got our potion of portals. So we'll take that, a new item discovered. And quest is now updated. What are we at? We're at 44%, so Elvira has a talent for brewing potions of portals, but the potion still smells awful. Off to see Rondasand, he waits for you at the portal, fair enough. Let's just double check and go down and see what he's doing. I obviously do want to still spend a bit of time here off camera, because I still want to work on getting the other monster hunts up to 100%. Right, And we will talk to him. If it does tell us to do it, we'll maybe have to stop it there and spend a bit of time making sure we've got everything from here. Right, you've lost me again. Too many big words, I'm not made for that. Precisely, I didn't either, so... Well, that's fine, as long as we actually get to where we're going, I'm sure we can try and find a way to get to Lasmanis from the past into the future from there, possibly. I'm fine with that. Now, I wonder when I'm going to be able to actually just jump back between the past and the future. It would be quite handy if I could do that, please. Oh, that's nice of you. Right, so let's take item, and we've got ourselves a new energy key, so we'll take that. Let's see, quest updated, activate the portal with the energy key that Rondasan gave you, then travel back to your own time. Okay, I don't really want to do that right now, because as I say, there is a few things I want to do on this island. Actually, off camera, I've actually been working on getting these monster hunts up to 100% in this area. I have actually went ahead and fought the bone troll again and got up to 33, so it's probably going to take me a wee while before I can get both of these up to 100%. I just want to kind of see if they actually drop any gear in the missing list of items there that you see that's still got question marks on them. So what I'm going to do, guys, I'm going to end it here just for now. I'm going to spend a bit of time in this area just basically, getting all that up to 100%, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, welcome back. So I've went off camera again and did a little bit more level grinding and finally got myself up to level 91, but more importantly I finally got to get the last two monster hunts that we did in this area up to 100%, which was the Bone Troll and the Prankster. There was a couple of items that we still had missing from the drop list, and one of them was the Royal Bracelet, which is an amulet for monsters, I think. And the Prankster finally managed to start dropping Crusader's Faith, which is a sword for Damien. So as you can see there, I've already got one that I've started upgrading at the moment, but I do have another one that's untouched. So the Crusader's Faith comes with 250 strength and 290 luck, comes with the skill Magic Blessing, which grants you 10 MP for every defeated monster. You may want to kind of change that to something better. And comes with 21 levels and 10 slots already prepared for you to actually start upgrading at the weaponsmith. So I think that's pretty much all I've done off camera. There is no other side quests that I can do here at the moment. This area here is still blocked off and we can't get into Thousand Roaches because we don't have the final key. So what we're going to do now is actually start heading into this teleporter. So let's use item, go in. From here on you won't be able to turn. That's fine, again we don't have any other side quests that we can do here at this point, so okay. Let's head through now and see what's going to happen. Right, quest updated, we're in North Tarun. The journey to the past was successful, talk to Rondasan in order to reach Lasmanis. Alright, let's see, that's fine, we're actually back here again. That means I should be able to start using that teleporter again. Okay, so we'll just go ahead and talk to him just now, see what he's got to say. Yeah, the portal's working, but it seems like it's blocked again. Actually, I do want to hear what the details were. If he tells us, it means we can start doing it ourselves. I'm afraid so, Asha, I think you're going to have to drink it. We went through a lot to bleed and get it, so you're damn well drinking it. I've kinda given up lifting this spell, to be honest with you. It's taking too long. then we'll just have to go to the Palace of Foresight to get the cookie key for the book that we've actually got. Doesn't sound too difficult to do as long as there's no big bad enemies in our way. Well, there's always going to be some uber evil super villain somewhere. We'll just have to take them on as well. Well, you've just got to have a little bit of faith, and even if it doesn't take us to Las Manas, we'll just deal with it there and then. No point worrying about it now. Then if the eyes turn up, we'll just have to deal with them like we've done so far. And whoever this Supreme Celestial is, I've got a suspicion it's probably the person that raised Damien. I've just got that feeling. It might not be, I might be totally misreading it for all I know, but I just feel like he would know something at least. Well, you know, Lane's always kinda hungry in a way. Oh, we're finally gonna drink this. Oh, need to watch yourself there. You don't want to start gagging in the bottle. Oh, there you go. He's taking a big swig. Look at that. It's a big bottle. I wouldn't necessarily say you've got to clean your teeth. I'd probably assume you'd maybe need mouthwash more than anything. Is he still gagging?
Ooh.
You're weird. Yeah, on to Las Manas. Well, thanks for all the help. I feel like you're going to disappear on us now. Right, let's deliver wanted items, okay. And take item. Right, we've got another energy key. Fair enough. Take that. Quest updated again. A family pack of mint chewing gum would help right now, but instead all you have available is an energy key which you can use to enter the portal to Las Manas. Okay, that's fine. Just want to very quickly talk to you again. Nothing? Alright. Well, what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to end it here for today. In the next episode, I'm possibly going to do some side quests if we have any available. If we end up not having any available, we'll continue on with our main quest to Las Manas. So until then, guys, thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all again next time.